Why is it many of us spend our days rehashing the past, rehearsing the past, living in the past, and being fearful of the future, and not really living in the present moment, not grasping the power of now? Well, we're going to find out this morning. This is Tom Karen with the Be Something Wonderful Studio of Higher Consciousness in San Diego, California. It's Tuesday morning. It's November 24, 2020. Welcome back. Guys, as I promised, I introduced and I said I was going to talk about this book today, A Course in Miracles. And I mentioned this when we talked about our lesson in forgiveness last night. This is the book. It's over 1,300 pages. It was dictated, it's published by the Foundation of Inner Peace, which is a nonprofit organization. And the writer of this book is Helen Schucman. I think that's how you say it, Schucman. Helen Schucman was a clinical psychologist that worked a PhD, that was a professor at the Columbia University in New York. She published this in 1976, although when she was asked back then about it, this is published not as her, as the author, because she said it was dictated from her, from Jesus, from that higher divine self, from that divinity. So if you can see, it says Foundation for Inner Peace. You can see that I've gone through this book quite a bit, and Foundation for Inner Peace. So The Course in Miracles, some have called it like another Bible, although it's different, right? The Bible, of course, is the best-selling book of all time. It's the most amazing book ever. It's sold over 5 billion copies. I think A Course in Miracles has been out there for a while. And it tells the story, Helen tells the story of how this came to her, right? When she was looking for a better way, right? She was battling it out with her colleagues, said there must be a better way. So her and another colleague, as she started getting these downloads, her colleague started typing it up. And this is how it took her 7 years. It took them 7 years to write A Course in Miracles. It's amazing. It was published in 1976. It sold over 3 million copies. What's the idea? A Course in Miracles. A Course in Miracles is what they call a total reversal in thinking. It's basically getting out of our ego state, and really getting into the state of love, that divinity, God. That is our natural state. So it's all about that. It's all about forgiveness. It's all about living in the present. It's all about living in love. Any place you open that book to, you can't argue with what it's saying. It's really truth in its purest form. It's really love in its purest form. It's divinity, which is pure. So here's a quote from the workbook. In A Course in Miracles, God cannot forgive sin because God does not condemn. Well, I'm going to read that again. God cannot forgive sin because God does not condemn. God does not need to forgive because he never condemns in the first place. This is the lesson that we talked about on forgiveness. When you forgive, so you are forgiven. There is so much power in forgiveness and letting go of all that junk that you're carrying, all of those grievances against yourself and others, right? The Course in Miracles takes the stance that they never happened, that you overlook them. Because many of us say, well, I buried the hatchet. Well, it's not a, but if you remember A Course in Miracles, or I forget where I read this, but if you remember where the hatchet is buried, you have it, it doesn't matter. You gotta forget where the hatchet's buried. Bury the hatchet, but forget where it's buried, right? To forgive and forget, like it never happened. This is the idea of true forgiveness. That it's impossible to sin against another. It's impossible to hurt another because we're all connected. It's impossible. You're hurting yourself if you hurt another. This is A Course in Miracles. It's really about stop that rehearsing the past and projecting the future. Live in the loving present. They call it the holy instant. We'll talk more. We'll do more lessons from the Course in Miracles. I really wanted to introduce this today to you. There's no future in the past. I love that quote. There is no future. It didn't come from the Course in Miracles. It came from another writer right down here. I'll have this all in the below the video. This quote, I think, sums it up all, guys. You are blocking yourself off whenever you're not in the present, in living in the present. Even if the past is great, right? Even if the past is wonderful, you're still, if you're dwelling on it and you're in reveling in it, that's okay. It makes you feel good, but you're still not in the present where all the action is. Guys, all the action is now. That's where life is. And really, I think I told you that quote yesterday from Roger Ebert. We only have now. Now just keeps moving. Now. Abraham Hicks talks about that hub. Now. It keeps moving. So guys, live in the now. It's really about miracle-mindedness. Forget where the hatchet is buried. Right? Forget it. To forgive, you are forgiven. To love, you are loved. To give is to receive, right? All of this. We'll talk about this. This is a big one, to give and receive. We'll talk about that more in future lessons. But that's what I wanted to introduce A Course in Miracles today. Let love in. Let go of this fear, guilt, sin, and condemnation. This all comes. We hold on to all of that when we don't forgive. When we get stuck in the past and we live in fear. Fear, guilt, sin, condemnation comes really from our ability not to forgive, the ability where we hold on to things, right? And this is the idea of A Course in Miracles, that it doesn't exist. God does not need to forgive because he doesn't condemn. God doesn't see the sin. Right? In our perfect holiness, sin doesn't exist. Right? Look, I'm not saying that bad things, that people don't do bad things in the world. They do. The idea is, though, is that if we see that, if that's where our attention is placed, then we make it real. The idea to forgive is to put your attention in love. Right? This is powerful. Forgiveness. And we talked about gratitude as we get close to Thanksgiving. That we'll talk more about that. But this is what I wanted to introduce this morning. I'll have another lesson today. Haven't thought about what we're going to talk about yet. A Course in Miracles. Helen Schucman, I think is how you say her name. Guys, an amazing book. As you can see, I've gone through it quite a bit. And what I love about this book, so it has the text where it talks a lot about this, a lot of truth in it. And then it has a workbook for 365 lessons for each day of the year. So I've been working on this all year. Not working on it. I love it. I read a day each day. I read one of the lessons, and you just continue to it. And each time I read it, something else occurs to me. Something other big thought that download from divinity. Course in Miracles. If you haven't read it, it's a lot to take in. If you want to get started and you don't, and the course just seems overwhelming for you because it can be overwhelming. This author, Pam Grout, wrote Making the Course of Miracles Easy. I forget the exact name of it. Just look her up, Pam Grout. That's Pam Grout, G-R-O-U-T. And just type in Google Pam Grout Course in Miracles. She also wrote E Squared, a couple really great books, New York bestseller E Squared. She makes the Course in Miracles easy. She's fun. She's funny. She keeps it light, but the tone is beautiful. It's the same stuff. It's about love, but it makes it a little bit easier to digest. You might want to start with that or do them both together. So guys, this is Tom. It's Tuesday morning. Welcome back. I will see you soon, later on this afternoon. Thanks for again having coffee with me this morning. This is Tom Karen with the Be Something Wonderful studio in San Diego, California. Until later today, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Remember the subscribe button anytime during the video, or that little cartoon of me with the headset. Hit that, subscribe, hit the notification button so you don't miss it, the videos. And don't forget to like the videos. That helps us, again, get the message out. It helps in the Google search. It helps everything. And why not? Why not? Guys, it's just a second. Okay, I'll see you later today.